What's good? It's Racky Fresh checking in. You're watching Link Up TV. Make sure you download that Link Up TV app on your iPhone. Get in tune, yeah.
I be that young nigga from Chicago. About to heat the city up and make it feel like Cabo. Yeah, watch these niggas try and take my shine. I told these foolies hard work and it'll come in time. For now, just watch me tell my bitch.
Man, my name, it's a cool story, you know what I'm saying? I'm a huge fan of movies. Been that way since I was a kid. Like the Power Rangers, like Three Ninjas. Both of them had two characters named Rocky that happened to be my favorite characters on the movie. My little homies, you know what I'm saying, used to call me that because that's the character I used to play when we used to act out the movies or whatever. And then when I got to high school, I was kind of known for the clothes and stuff that I wore. People always called me Fresh. So I put it together, not necessarily thinking that it would become anything big. But yeah, now that's my name. Journey of my rap career probably started in 2008. That's when I first really started rapping. 2009, I put out my first mixtape. I had a release party for that mixtape, which was actually a release show. And that was my first show ever, first sold out show as well. It happened to be sold out. Over 600 people in Chicago came out to see me perform for the first time. And once I saw that reaction to my first time putting out music, it kind of was a springboard for me to just continue to put out, you know what I'm saying, projects. And with that being said, I put out three mixtapes. Leading into me getting signed, the project that got me signed was called Driving 88, and Rick Ross heard that project, and he flew me out to LA. You know what I'm saying? We had an excellent relationship from the jump, just related, you know what I'm saying? And with that being said, it motivated me to do business with him. Well, now I'm signed to Maybach Music Group in Atlantic, and we dropping straight heat. I'm saying I had a bunch of different opportunities I could have signed with pretty much any label, you know what I'm saying? It's probably like two or three labels that probably didn't reach out to me, and if I would have, you know what I'm saying, held off, they probably would have. But it was just something about that MMG vibe, you know what I'm saying, that I knew was home for me. And so with that being said, it feels great. I feel right where I'm supposed to be, and I'm loving the way things are going. Man, I'm getting a lot of new fans off of it. I think when Ross, you know what I'm saying, like puts together a record where it features a person like J. Cole, Wale, Meek, and then you put a new artist like myself on it, I think that it only opens up doors for better opportunities. Same thing with the record that I did with Fabulous Ross and Gunplay. You know, songs like that just really help, you know, take me to another level. And it kind of made certain people that may not have wanted to listen to me before, you know what I'm saying, kind of tune in a little bit. And with that, I've been able to get a lot of new fans and gain a lot of new interest. So I definitely appreciate that project. The biggest things I had to overcome, I feel like it's just being patient. You know what I'm saying? I feel like when you're young, you just want everything so fast. You know what I'm saying? And you don't really understand what that comes with. And also, in many cases, when you get stuff too early, you know what I'm saying, it really don't last too long. And so with that being said, you know, in my younger years and me still being a young dude, I just had to, you know what I'm saying, really like teach myself that it's okay to pace things. And I think that's the biggest thing, is just me wanting to be successful so bad and be at the top of the game right now, and understanding that it always doesn't work that way. And that doesn't mean that it's not gonna happen in the future. I think that's just like the biggest thing. I don't really feel too much pressure, man. I honestly, you know, I'm still young and I'm still getting better, and I'm still challenging myself just to, you know what I'm saying, continue to figure out ways to do this in a different way and really reach the people. And I feel like I'm getting better with it. So with that, I don't really feel no pressure. I see the fruits of hard work with the team that I'm on. And also, I understand that when you're original, you always have the ability to create your own lane to the point where your only competition really is yourself. So with that being said, it's just like, man, it's really no pressure. I'm just working and trying to have fun with it. I think my family, you know what I'm saying, is one thing, the number one thing, just making sure that they good and being able to provide for them at a young age. I feel like that's an awesome thing that keeps me motivated. But then also just being happy with my life, you know what I'm saying. As a young kid, I always wanted to be rich. I always wanted to be successful. I had a top of the line everything. And so it's just with that, you know what I'm saying, and having that drive, I think that's, you know, two things that really keep me on my toes. Biggest highlight of my career, maybe actually coming out here to London, man. You know, I always wanted to leave the country. coming from Chicago, it's not a lot of people that make it this far as like just traveling wise. And so with that being said, you know, just to be here, man, it's a dope feeling to be rocking sold out shows with Mac Miller. And two, you know, signing that deal with Ross, like that's somebody I was a fan of long before I started rapping, you know what I'm saying? And when I was in high school and he first came out with Hustlin', that record really impacted crazy. So to know that, you know what I'm saying, that's my brother now, it's a crazy feeling. So those two things. Man, definitely anything is possible, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people that still doubt me to this day that have doubted me when I first started rapping. And I've still been able to progress more and more every year ever since I started making music. And I think it's just having that determination and that tunnel vision to where you're able to receive criticism, but at the same time, you don't take it to the heart too much. And also to make sure that you don't judge others. You know, I feel like a lot of people go wrong when they start worrying about what other people are doing and judging what they do and not focusing on themselves. So I think the best advice is just focus on yourself, try to have quality, keep tunnel vision. It was supernatural, you know what I'm saying? That was just me and my friends just chilling around Chicago. I don't really get to do that as much as I used to. It's because I'm always traveling. But, you know, when Ross let me know that he wants to use that record for a single, he just really, his biggest thing was like, man, you got to wear a D. Rose jersey. And it's funny because that's what I was thinking about doing anyway. So, you know, to see me and him being on the same page again, it wasn't nothing new. But I think just putting my real friends, you know what I'm saying, the people that I really grew up with that have known me since I was 2 years old, you know what I'm saying, putting them in the video with me, it was something that needed to be done. And it just was a natural feel. One of the favorite tracks, whew, man, I think it's this record called 20s. That I did, you know what I'm saying? It kind of sums up basically what I'm 22 now, so like it summed up age 20 to, you know what I'm saying, me turning 30. Whenever, you know, when that time comes, it really touched on the things that I want to do and, you know, just how I want to be perceived. I feel like that's one of my favorite records. What's next, man? A lot of dope music, you know what I'm saying? We're going to be going crazy with the visuals as well. But then, too, you know, that album is getting ready to be coming up soon. Not too soon, but it's definitely coming. So be on the lookout for that. And then also make sure you get that Self-Made 3 that's in stores right now. I got a single off of there called God is Greatest on iTunes. So you can get that and a bunch of other free records that I got out on the internet. It's this joint called Kush Do, produced by my homie LPZ and my homie Cam, and that features Wiz Khalifa. I think people should check that out, along with Self-Made 3. And yeah, man, just a bunch of new music is coming. So yeah, be on the lookout for it.
Remember to download the official Link Up TV app for all the latest mixtapes, news, and more.